is really pretty. Hello everybody, happy Valentine's Day. Today I'm gonna share with you how I'm gonna rearrange the flowers that I bought and then put together inside this one. And this is gonna be for my wife. So it looked really pretty and really nice. This was one of the one with the flower that I gave for her past few years ago. And every year I still using the same one, except for I'm gonna rearrange different flower for my wife, so she will be happy for it. So the two flowers that I got from Costco, this one and that one, and I know for sure this is rose, but the rest of these I can't tell you the name of the flower. To me, it's not only about buying the flower for the ladies, but also when you rearrange and make it look pretty, match with their personality or matching with the way that they look, it will make them even happier. So not only to go out there and then get a flower, everybody can do that, and then go to your loved one and then give it to them, of course they're happy, but if you rearrange it and make it look better, then they're even happier than they used to. So this is how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna cut and then put all of them in here, and then I'm gonna show you after the war. So
here we go, this is all the flowers. And now I'm gonna rearrange and put them in here so that it will look much better. I'm gonna put some water in there first. Maybe like half. And then once you have all the flour in, then you can put in the rest of it. But for now, I should put in half water in this the small container. And then you're gonna start with rows, and then you're trying to put them 12 rows in here and make sure that they're more open. I'm not really good at this, but I mean, if you put your time and effort into this, I'm pretty sure that your loved one gonna be very happy about it. So depending on how tall you want it to be, I think that it wanna be this tall is good enough. I'm like too tall, it might fall out, so I'm gonna cut this right here. There we go. And then you can put it in. Normally you don't need the leaves. You just take it like only maybe the small one, but if you don't have small, you should only leave like one of the leaves left per flower. And whenever you see the flower ready tear out, you take it out, make sure that it looks good. There. You see? And then the rest of it is you're gonna do it the same way. Make sure that you know how tall that is, using the one that you cut earlier, and then cut the rest of the row. I'm gonna put all of them together and then cut at once so that it's saving me time. Okay, there's the other rows as well. So, See, you don't have to be perfectly on the side, because you need to put them rearrange it, so some of them might be shorter than the other. I'm gonna put all of them in here. And then again, trim all the one that that you don't need the leaves, because it's not gonna look good. The one in the from the bottom up, you only need about few of them, not too many. And make sure those are the one that fresh, not the one that look bad or fall apart. There, this one I'm probably gonna cut it too. So only a few that I'm gonna leave like a few, maybe one or two. That one is good. Like this one, it looked good, so I'm gonna leave that. And then this one, probably I don't need that many, so I'm gonna trim this out. There. And don't lift anything that below is, it's not gonna look good. Can you see? Alright. And then they also give you extra of the leaf. I don't know what is the name of this, but it's really nice to have it. Make sure that anything that's bad, you take it away. You cut them out, you trim them out. And then I'm gonna put all these inside. Make sure that it's lower than your flowers, so that it will make your flowers stand out. Once I have all these in, then later on I'm gonna show you how to put make sure that it looks better. So this is still too tall for me. So I'm probably gonna cut it a little bit lower, because I can tell that this is a little bit tall. Even the row itself, I think that I can take about half an inch, maybe even like 1/4 of an inch, because it's still too tall. There. Yeah, I think it looks good now. So I'm gonna start to put this in. Okay, there's some that's really tall. Put them out. Put them like you separate them in quarter, so it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, so you can rearrange. Make sure that the lower one's gonna be in the bottom, and then the taller one's gonna be in the middle, and so that you make it like that. All right, more to come. If you see the one that's falling, I mean, like, it's not really straight, but it's like that, then make sure you put it on the other far side, and then let it fall on the other side, and then you're gonna rearrange the other one so that it will cover that side. It's all about how you wanna look. Make sure that it looks better. Let me start with touching more. Doing these flowers sometimes might take some time. It's not gonna be like quick, because you want it to look good and you want it to be special. Might as well just spend some time to make it look special. So that's the rose, and then now it's the other part. This one might look good in the center, so I'm gonna put this in the center. And then the other one. I mean, if it's only rose, I mean, it looks good, it looks pretty. Rose by itself is already pretty. To be honest, sometimes we don't need to put the other extra flower in, but it just depends on the person that receive. If you feel like they like more color, or rose is a little bit boring for them, then you can do it like this so that it mix, and if they won't feel just one, every year is the same. So I'm gonna put this around wherever I see that it can make a difference. This one is a little bit too tall. Cut it down. Mm-hmm. This one. Put it over here. Okay, this one is gonna be. So you have one on this side, now it's on the other side. There we go. Yeah, so you have two new flowers. I think my wife is liking the purple color. Side. Okay, now we're gonna continue with more flowers. This one already, one side on this side, which means I'm gonna put the other one over here. Make sure that it's gonna be the right side, otherwise when you put it in, it's not gonna fit. Okay, this side, half this flowers. Look nice to me, look good. All right. Let me see what next. So we have some of them on this side for the pink one. So now we're gonna put it on the other side. Normally, they will give you the even number of the branch of the flowers, so that because it's Valentine's, so it's all gonna be together at least 2, 4, 8 or something like that. But it's not gonna be single, like the 13 or 7. You don't like that. So the same thing over here. As you can see, there's one already. I put it right here. So there's another one, so that it pair together. I mean, all they have like 4 of them together. And the way that you put it in, I mean, it's just the number, it does itself make a difference of meaning. You don't want to be single. Valentine is about a couple, celebrate. And even if you are not having a girlfriend, and you just don't like to spend time with the other people, you can still, I mean, even, like those people, normally they're gonna have friends, like they're playing game, or they spend time with something. You in love, Valentine is about love, couple. Or even if you don't have couple, you can love your parents, you can love brother, sister. Not that kind of love where it's not natural, but the love of like relationship. All right, it looks nice on this side. You want the lips to cover, make sure they are mixed together and they don't fall like really like that. Make sure that it's strong. It can show like powerful and it's like it's, the form is really what I can tell is like you don't need anything to wrap it, but it still stands in a almost straight line. Okay, so we have another pink one. So we have one over here. If you have extra, put it on this side. And if you have extra, you're gonna put it on the other side. All right. It's gonna look good on this side. This side has quite a few. All right, I'm gonna put it back here. Look nice. Okay, I'm gonna have This one, because I have one over here, you can either to have it on the other side or on the front. I would prefer it on the back. I'm gonna share with you what is it at the end result so you can see how it look. But to be honest, like you spend, some people, I saw there's some kind of mix together already, but it's about $50. And it's not really, to me, it's not really that pretty at all. So the way that I want is, I want to mix them together so that it will look better that way. You see, now I want some, now I want some other flowers. There's two more over here. So I'm just gonna take a look. I have one over here. I need another one on the other side. And then this one's gonna be in the center. So, have this. There. This one's gonna be a side. And you don't have to be good, to be honest. As long as you spend some time and then you rearrange things, you can show your loved one that you really care for her, and you make these flowers for her. All right, look good on that side. Cut these. Make sure they only have one leaf, or you don't even need one. And if you have the back one outside, the flower on the outside is not good. You can take them out, and then you're gonna put them on where they are not yet. Careful. Okay, I'm missing something in the middle, which is perfectly for that. This one right here. I don't even know what this is, but to me, doesn't matter what that is. As long as you know how to put them together, you are good. Mm-hmm. Now I wonder if I have enough size for everything. Look at that. There's some more. Okay, so I saw that I have extra, but if I put this one over here, it takes too much space over here, but there's already one white one. I have one white one left, so I'm gonna put it on the other side of this one right here. So make sure that you have enough space, and then you're gonna put this in the middle. There. The middle is the place where you want it a little bit higher than the outside. The outside is to make it look like an umbrella, where the top gonna be showing from top down. Careful. And flower is really, you need to be gentle with the flower, because these flowers, sometimes if you use too much force, then it's not happy about it, and it's gonna fall apart. So look at this, it's already look really nice. All right. Okay, let's see. I am done, pretty much almost done. There's some on the leaves outside that if I want to, for example, like this one, it look really cool. It look bright, and I want to see. I'm gonna using one of the chair to stand up and see how can it be better. It's gonna be in the middle over here, and it's gonna be that side because it's gonna make the bright on that side gonna be look good. So I'm gonna cut it down this much. There. Make sure that you have enough space for it. There. Down a little. Wow, this looks nice now. I also have another one, and this is gonna be on the other side. And you can use that as this. Only one small container on the top is enough for everything that two flower already mixed together. Everything already put and it fit. Amazingly, it fit. And then this one is gonna be on the two sides so that it will branch it out. I don't wanna cut it too deep. This one's gonna be a little because I'm gonna use it for over here. The pot is already really, really tight. But this one's gonna be on this side so that it will hold it on that side. And then this over here, this side. There we go. You see, I utilize everything from the two. And finally, it's the left one. This one is in the middle. There. It's perfectly. Do that. Amazing. Here, you see? It looks really nice. Let me take the phone out so that I can share with you from the top down. What it look. See this one, I can cut the middle. really balancing out really nice, right? Alright, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you guys on the next video. See ya!